I mean, where the fuck should I really even start? I got hoes that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my niggas cross the street living large. Thinking back to the fact that they dead. Thought my raps were the facts, so they sat with the bars. I got two phones, one need a charge. Yeah, they twins, I could tell they ass apart. I got big packs coming on the way. I got big stacks coming out to save. I got Lil Max with me, he the wave. It's a big gap between us and the game. In the next life, I'm trying to stay paid. When I die, I put my money in a...
So, this is actually my first weekend staying in Delaware. And I've really been taking it easy. Like, I just got back from Atlanta and Detroit. I moved the rest of my stuff here. And I honestly just want to, you know, enjoy my time in my apartment. I don't necessarily think I'm going to be alone, per se. And I probably will end up going to DC tomorrow. But I want you guys here with me because this is my first weekend out here on the East Coast. So, I'm about to cook breakfast and, you know, get myself together. I have a lot of things to do today. I have to get my apartment together. I don't know how much of my apartment I'll be showing off right now because I do want to give you guys like a furnished apartment tour, but everything's not here yet. But I have a lot of stuff that I want to do in here. Like I want to do something to the walls. I want to get like a coffee table, a rug. So that video probably won't be out for a while because like I have to get my finances together. I spent so much fucking money moving. So yeah. All right, guys. So I literally just got done cleaning my apartment. I'm about to run some errands, so first I want to go and get my eyebrows cleaned up because I have not been in so fucking long. Like, I don't think I've been since April. Do y'all hear that noise? I think that's my dishwasher. Anyway, I just got done cleaning the apartment. I'm about to go get my eyebrows cleaned up. I want to wash my face, brush my teeth because I didn't do that. I literally just got up and started moving around. And yeah, I think I'm also gonna go to the YMCA here because it's literally 0.4 miles away from my house, so I can walk there rather than driving 20 minutes to LA Fitness. So I have to go there, cancel my membership, and then I might get a few things from the store. That's what I'm doing for now. And then I think I may go on a little run later. And then I may go to the club tonight. Who knows what I'm gonna do, but y'all are here. All right. And believe it or not, my hair actually is cut. I just got a cut yesterday. It's kind of just like looking a mess right now because I didn't do anything to it. Finished product. She actually did it really fast, and I was so scared that she pulled my whole eyebrow off, but she did it really fast, and I think she did a great job. Now I'm off to the YMCA, or I'm probably gonna go to LA Fitness first to cancel my membership. So I did a walk around like the facility, and it's like actually updated and really nice, and I kinda don't want to cancel my membership because it's only 17 minutes away from my house, but then I think that it's super valuable to like be able to walk to like the place that you work out, and it's so convenient because my building does not have like any gym or like anything like that, so there's literally no amenities in that sense. So like if I wanted to work out, I would literally have to get in my car and drive. The thing that I hate about the East Coast is that parking is fucking ridiculous. Like I have this big ass truck and I don't like doing that, so I would much rather just like walk to the gym on days when it's sunny or like when it's not raining like today. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go home, I'm gonna get my workout stuff, and I'm gonna see if like at the YMCA they can let me take a tour and then give me a pass. And honestly, like I'll probably just go on a swim because I want to do that, and then maybe I'll run too. I don't know if you should run or swim first. I don't know, but I'm about to handle it. And I really do want a smoothie, but I'm supposed to be budgeting, and I'm going to talk about that a little bit later. But like, if y'all only knew how much like moving to Atlanta, then moving to Delaware, all in a matter of like 3 months, like actually cost me, plus getting rid of my car back home, not this car, but my car back home, bitch, I feel the burn, like for real. So I decided to go into Dick's Sporting Goods because if I'm gonna go on a swim, I need some goggles. So I need some goggles for this. And yeah, honestly, I might go to the mall after too, because even though I need to budget, I need to get a new shirt for DC because I just wanna feel like I'm doing something for me, you know? I just wanna feel like that. So are these the Hoochie Daddy shorts that everybody's been talking about? Or are these the Hoochie Daddy shorts? Because I'm thinking that I'm gonna grab some. I already have a few pair at home, but you know, let's just do it. Okay guys, so I'm in H&M and I'm really trying to figure out, is this shirt cute? Because I really like it. I love the words on the collar and I want it. It is only like $14, so who can beat that? But then I saw this other little set, like it's right here. It has a little polo. And like, I know H&M is like fast fashion, it's kind of cheap and the quality is not always the best, but something quick to wear, like I feel like this would be pretty dope. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comments.
Y'all really will not believe that when I went to the mall and checked the hours for the YMCA, they were closed. So the hours is from 7 to 4, and I didn't even stress myself out by looking because I can almost just imagine it being closed tomorrow and not being able to go. So I just don't know what to do. Like,
Okay, so let's talk. Here's why I'm stressed out. I'm stressed out because, and I mean, I think that the reason I'm stressed out is like the reason why a lot of people are stressed out now in this time, this day and age. It's because I literally just want to live a lifestyle that I probably shouldn't be living, but I'm probably not gonna change my current lifestyle to, y'all feel what I'm saying? Like, I wanna spend all of my money going out to the club and turning up and doing all these crazy things and going on luxurious trips and this and that. And what I'm saying is, I'm going to do that. Like, I'm going to continue to do that. I'm gonna continue to go on trips. I'm gonna continue to swipe my card. But the issue is, the way that I have to do this is, I have to find another job. And I don't mean like, get a new job. I mean, I wanna get a new job. But I kind of just got in this position and I want to excel at it, but I need to find a second job. And that's not like hard at all. And I know so many people who do it. I know people who have 2 and 3 corporate jobs, especially right now with everybody working remotely. I feel like I can do that. But while I'm waiting and while I'm getting there, it's stressful. And then just keeping everything up is a lot. Like I told you guys, I spent so much money while I was in Atlanta. All I was doing was eating, drinking, doing hookah. I would never trade it for the world. I had an amazing time. I made some great friends, but it's just a lot. And I'm walking around this park right now and it's really cool. I'm gonna go on a run shortly, but yeah, that's like my struggles in life right now. But other than that, like everything is good. I'm not hurting in any ways. Like, it's like the problem with America. Like, I just want more money. I want more money. I want to do more things. And I want to have a hot boy summer. And I don't want to have any fucking limits. That's what it is. That's the problem. I don't want any limits and I don't want to be smart. I want to be dumb and I just want to spin. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk. That's it.
Hey guys. So all jokes aside, like as I'm sitting here editing, like I don't want to come off as insensitive or ungrateful in any way. But basically what I'm saying is, we go to school, right? You go to school, you pay all this money, in my case over $100,000 that I have to pay back. There were probably some mistakes on my end, but that also came from not being from a very financially savvy background. And now that I'm here, I'm not one of those people that's gonna sit back and, you know, wait for Joe Biden to pay off my loans, because we see how that's going. And in my case, $10,000, which is what everybody's talking about, is only probably about a year of interest for me. So when I talk about things like not being enough, a lot of that goes into like my overambition when it comes to getting all of my student loans and everything paid for, and then all these other things that I have to now take over as an adult. And I think just the adjustment period behind all of that is a lot, and it causes a lot of stress for me. But yeah, that's basically what I was talking about. So that's
it. What's up guys? So the way it's looking is, it's about 6:15 p.m. not a.m. I'm about to get ready and go to DC. Last night I ended up going to Philly
my best friend and a few other people just ended up in DC, so it's like I have to go. And I was trying to tell myself yesterday that, you know, maybe I don't need to go, maybe I need to sit down, but I miss my best friends. I'm about to take a shower and get dressed, and then I will talk to you guys shortly. Hey guys, so I'm getting ready to go out. I'm getting ready to drive to DC, and we're about to have a fucking ball. So I literally have gotten a lot done. This day has kind of actually been a little bit stressful for me because I had a meeting with one of my dealers, so I just got done with that. Of course, I didn't wear this. I went in the house and changed really quick, but I do want to work out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and take a swim. And yes, I'm driving there today, but that's because I'm only going to go to lunch with my friend after. He's going to be here like an hour and a half, so my swim is only going to be about 30-45 minutes. But yeah, other than that, I just have to go pick my friend up from Philly, and then we'll probably go out there. I do want to explore a lot of this area just because I haven't really got a chance to see a lot of Delaware, and of course, like, I've never really been here outside of coming to look for an apartment and meeting my other dealerships. So, you know, it's just a lot, and life is just a mess. Alrighty, so I just made it to the YMCA. I'm about to go for my little swim, and this is probably gonna give me so much dopamine because I haven't been in the water for like so long. I mean, I did just go like swimming, but it wasn't like swimming like I'm about to do. Like, now I'm about to swim laps, so it's gonna be a workout. I don't even think I'll need to work out anymore after I do this. So YMCA has left a bad taste in my mouth today. This bitch in the parking lot, I almost got into it with this old lady. And I mean, it was my fault. But one thing that really irritates me is when people say the same thing. So the parking lot is fairly small and there's like a direction in which like there's a rotation of the parking lot. I went the wrong way. I didn't see the arrows. So clearly the lady all the way back, like literally 40 fucking yards, saw me coming. She blows her horn. Cool, cute. I move my big ass truck out of her way. She pulls up beside me and says, "Didn't you see the arrows?" I said, "No, but there's enough space for you to get around. I've moved, I've created this space." She said, "Well, we don't like it when people go the wrong way here." I said, "I'm gonna say it again. I've pulled to the side, go around. I didn't see the arrows. Sorry about it." So she says it again. I said, "Stop talking to me about these damn arrows. Are you gonna go?" Because what the fuck do you want from me? Bitch, I said, "I'm sorry, I gotta go." I really, 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 really do not want to get into it with somebody's grandma, but just stop trying me. Okay, so I've changed clothes about 18,000 times at this point, and I decided that I'm gonna go have lunch. So I'm meeting up with my friend Ken. We're about to go to this place called Deco, downtown Delaware. And they have like really good food. They have really good tacos. I know they have a chicken and waffle spot. I might honestly just get sushi this time because I kind of had a little bit of Chipotle yesterday, so I don't really want Mexican because I don't need my asshole to be on fire. Yeah. Guys, this was actually the building that I was gonna get like my apartment in. We didn't go look at it, but because of like COVID rent prices, like it started off being $1,500 for like 590 square feet, which is tiny as hell. But then once that price shit changed, a 590 square foot apartment became $1,800, $1,900. And that was just like not really doable for me. I'm walking into Deco. I'll probably have a little lemon drop. It's Friday, whatever. Finally at the barber shop. Let's see what my boys can do with this. Honestly, if they don't do a good job this time, I'm kind of over this place. They treated me well last time and the time before that, and they always got me in here. It's just a matter of like all the extra shit. I don't need it and I have little patience. Like, I just feel like I'm a really good customer. So it's like, if you guys don't get me straight the first time and I have to keep on looking at people and then it's in this shop, like, I'll just go to another one. Okay guys, so I would say that he buttered my hair. He did, he fixed me up real nice, and I'm really, really happy about it, to be quite honest. Okay, so yeah, I definitely think that I found the barber that I'm gonna keep using out here, because he did a really good job. Now, one thing that I told him that I don't necessarily really like, because I just really don't like it, but he used enhancements on my hair again, and I think I mentioned that to y'all before, like, I don't need it. I'm not balding. To me, you can see through the hair and it makes your skin black, and that does not look natural to me. And just, again, like, I don't need it. I'm not balding. So, yeah. But other than that, like, I feel like once I wash it out, it's going to be good. And I'm going to the Roots picnic, so I need to go find outfits. So I'm about to take a shower, get this shit out of my hair, and bam, bada bing, bada boom. Hey, so I just picked up part two of the Hoochie Daddy starter pack. Bam, bam, and bam. I just wanted y'all to know I've got the most iconic shirts, and I'm not going to show you right now, but the pictures are going to be lit. The videos are going to be lit. Everything's going to be lit. Hoochie Daddy season. So, I've made it home, and my apartment's a mess. Like, look at it. It's in shambles. So, it's Saturday, and I think one thing that I didn't tell you guys was happy motherfucking Pride Month. Look at this. Equality. It's so cute. Happy Pride Month, bitches. Now, I'm about to show you guys my shirt that I'm gonna wear tomorrow. So cute. And it really represents this month so well. And it has one of the most iconic divas in the R&B category. Yeah. Some people even call her the Queen of Christmas. Yeah, look.
I'll charge you next time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll take a Pedialyte, and I mean, yeah, give me a water, and then also, can I have a mimosa? Look at my little pride drink on Black Gay Pride Month. Friend, what is this called?
Aviation.
This is an Aviation. I'm at Wilma's in Wilmington, Delaware.
Where?
You want to...
Danny Coleman, where you at? Danny Coleman, where you at?
Hi, it's me, Danny Coleman.
Yeah, we
am.
Hey, my friend.
And you know you've been through better, baby, but you won't try for me.
What's up, YouTube? Roderick Martez back again, and today is my birthday vlog. Today is not my birthday. My birthday was actually yesterday, and I had a great time. But today is June 9th, and I'm about to get ready to go to dinner with a friend in Baltimore. Yesterday, I went to Philly. I had dinner at this place called Budokan. So good. It tasted like, you know, shit. It was Asian fusion food. It was great. But yeah, so I'm about to go to a restaurant. I don't know where my friend is taking me. You guys have met Ken. That's who I'm going with. But while I'm getting ready, I went to Ulta.
I picked up a whole bunch of stuff. I picked up this hyaluronic acid serum from The Ordinary. I dropped mine the other day. It broke all over the floor, so I needed something new. I also picked up this Tree Hut Sugar Face Scrub. It's an AHA exfoliator in there as well. And I picked it up because I used the Tree Hut scrub like on my butt. So I figured this would be pretty good too, and it's brightening. So I'm gonna use it for like right here. I actually shave under my chin like with the razor, and a lot of people, especially like black men, that doesn't really work well for, but it doesn't really cause me a lot of problems. However, I do always get like the same 2 and 3 bumps right here. So I'm really only using it for that, and I'm using it to brighten those up. And I also got this 24/7 moisture hydrating day and night cream from Tula Skincare for my birthday. They gave it to me as a present. So we are still celebrating my birthday, and as you can see, my hair is black-ish. I went ahead and did it alone because I just did not feel like recording that. But today we have my girl Aaron.
What's going on?
And Rock. Oh wait.
I wanna ride.
So yeah, we are at Six Flags in Jersey. Everything is like super close to Delaware. It was literally only an hour to get here. Aaron, how much of a tourist do you think you are?
100%.
100?
Yeah.
Have you been having a wonderful time in Delaware?
It's been okay. Sorry, I'm playing. I'm playing. It's been amazing. I'm so glad I got to come see you. You know, I miss you dearly.
Did you like Philly yesterday?
Philly was a good time. I'm ready to go back.
We're going back tonight.
Because I ain't gonna show out.
Brock, have you enjoyed Delaware for the little bit of time you've been here?
I'm here for 2 seconds.
But literally, you've been in the car. That's
and I haven't experienced Delaware. I've been experiencing every other city but Delaware. Mm. But yeah, we going to Philly. I'm worried about Philly. I'm trying to see the Philly niggas.
That's what you're trying to see?
I'm trying to get me a Philly nigga with a Philly steak.
A Philly steak? A nice or a hot dog?
A Philly steak. Yeah.
So currently, right now, me and my friends are getting ready to go out, and nobody's ready.
I am ready.
Nobody's ready.
I'm always ready.
You're not ready.
I am ready. I'm always ready.
You guys aren't ready.
Who's not ready?
Get up.
Can you get those keys in your hand?
They're in my pocket. Jonathan, he stole the lanyard. Stop brushing your hair. Come on, let's go.
I don't brush my hair.
I'm about to beat everyone's ass. Mm-hmm. I'm about to whoop ass tonight.
Yes. Brock is very cute.
How was your food?
Well, it doesn't matter because I'm still depressed.
How was your food, Brock? That's how you feel? Okay. Aaron, how was your food?
It was tasty. I will eat it again.
Have a great rest of your day, guys.
Thank you so much.
Hey, hey. Roddy is back. Hair is black. And JB's recording me, I think. Are you recording me? Okay, and what? I've got all these messy bitches in my tiny Delaware apartment. Aaron. And we got Carisha and Diddy. So we're about to go to DC, I think. If these bitches would get the fuck up.
Why? So we could be asked for a W-2 before we get let into the door? Fuck. So with us,
we getting money. Yeah, we getting money over here. This dramatic bitch.
I want to go to New York where there's real niggas and real people. And real culture.
Did you just throw a hookah tip at me? You're so tacky.
Oh, I'm taking a nap.
What should the conversation be about?
No, he was talking about for the camera. This looks so good.
Where am I going?
High quality.
Just I've been DC for now.
Okay, so
we're Or I've been secrets.
We're finally leaving the house at 5 p.m.
Is it 5?
5:15, actually.
Somebody actually predicted that we would leave at 5.
Me.
Really? I thought you were going to sleep.
Secret. It's in D.C. on U Street. We're going to make our way south this time versus north, right?
Mm-hmm. South on 95. Mm-hmm. Now, Ray, the roads are kind of treacherous. But you're from Detroit, so I know you got this.
The gay club?
Treacherous.
The gay club.
All of U Street is.
Secret? The gay club?
No. Secret on U Street. That's not good. It feels so good to be, like, in the backseat of the car.
Yeah,
I'm over here killing myself.
That's when we had a mom last night. She was cold. Okay, but Roger, let's talk.
What are we talking about?
You can't go to sleep this time.
Why?
You can have a whole podcast here.
Let's play.
Alright guys, thank you so much for watching my birthday vlog. This is pretty much the end of this. I'm closing it out. I'm about to get ready and go to the gym. It's currently Monday. I just had a long day at work. I'm ready to unwind. And I'm about to edit this video and get it out to you guys soon. So, thanks. Bye.